We are on the set of PTE's latest production of Vigil, possibly the way I feel that we should be doing breakfast television. From a bed. I'm joined by two of the cast members. I have Doreen Brownstone and Michael Spencer Davis here with me. And let's talk a little bit about your comfy spot here, Doreen. How much of the play do you spend in bed?
A great deal. A great deal. But I do get a chance to get out and do other things. But most of it is here, and it's very comfortable. I don't mind.
Well, thank you for letting me snuggle in here with you.
Welcome.
The production is called Vigil, and you're the two main roles in the play, the two roles in the play. Let's talk a little bit about the story and about this production.
Well, it's about a man who comes back to look after his aging and dying aunt. And he's a bit of a misanthrope, and he doesn't actually like people, so he's not really very good at looking after her. But, and in a little bit of a way, he doesn't really want to be here at the same time. So it's a very black comedy, it's very, very funny, but through the course of the play, he learns to love her and care for her, and that sort of thing.
And it's not your first time in the role either, actually. Back in 1997, you played this very same role. How is it different doing it now?
It's extremely different. It's brand new because I've completely forgotten the other play. I remember the director, of course. But really, honestly, this is brand new to me. Which is good, because I wouldn't want to argue with Bob about messing up because I did that the last time. Because I don't remember what I did the last time. So this is fine.
It's kind of the benefit of time that way. You mentioned sort of the dark humor, Michael, as well. Let's talk a little bit about Morris Panichin's writing. That's something that, it's dark, but there's also a poignancy to his writing as well.
Yes, that's very, very true. The dark comedy, because the dark comedy underneath it has a real foundation to it of someone who's desperate and is really looking for love. And then Morris always manages to bring around a twist at the end that makes you realize that this guy really is just sort of sad and lonely, like a lot of people are.
Well, and it's interesting, we're getting kind of a handle on the dynamic between your two characters. You two have worked together in the past, though, as
yes.
Well. Both have histories in theater in Winnipeg. Let's talk a little bit about what that dynamic is for you to work now with Michael.
Well, there's a joke here involved, because the last time that we worked together, it was on an amateur play written by Nick Mitchell.
I like how you help each other out.
Yeah, and directed by Pear Brask. And there was a part in the play where we both grabbed for the phone, and I let it go, and boom, in his eye. Well, that was what I remember. So the first time I saw him for this play, I said, "You want the phone in the face now or later?"
And he's been coming to rehearsal with protective eye gear ever since. What are you really most looking forward to in bringing this play to audiences? What do you hope people get out of it?
They're not a candle.
I think they'll have a really good time. It's a very, very funny play. And it's very quirky, and it'll be something that they probably haven't seen for quite a while.
Really quickly, Doreen, I have to ask you, what motivates you to take on such a big task as performing this production every night for several nights?
I'm an actor. No, this is a chance to do it and then retire with grace. Ah. Grace retires with Grace.
Oh, there we
That's
go.
The character's name is Grace.
Yeah.
Tied it all together for me. I didn't even have to do that. Mm-mm. Thank you so much. You can check out Vigil at Prairie Theatre Exchange until December 7th. Back to studio.